الوادي نمضي أسودا لا نخشى الوغادي نمضي جنودا.
IDCA is a non-profit organisation and was founded in 1998. Currently operating from 86 Auburn Road in Auburn, almost exclusively staffed by volunteers, they provide the wider community with authentic Islamic literature such as books, videos, DVDs, CDs and audio cassettes. IDCA has its own video and audio production and distribution facilities and work tirelessly to raise community awareness about Islam. IDCA currently runs classes and lessons for men and women up to 3 times a week. And provides Quran school on weekends for children between the ages of 5 and 15. Their bookshop, along with IDCA's volunteers, service both the Muslim and non-Muslim communities by providing dawah through a wide range of products, such as books on hadith, sunnah, children's stories, as well as providing Islamic clothing, perfumes, prayer clocks, and many more. للرب سجودا حي حشودا. With the youth being one of IDCA's main focuses, they provide support through counselling services, information and education. They organise regular activities such as sporting outings, skirmish, barbecues and camps. Each month, notable local and interstate speakers are invited to give lectures on important and relevant topics. This also extends to well-known international lecturers, although less frequently due to the costs involved.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Begin with the recitation of the Quran. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. عما يتساءلون عن النبأ العظيم الذي هم فيه مختلفون كلا سيعلمون ثم كلا سيعلمون ألم نجعل الأرض مهادا والجبال أوتادا وخلقناكم أزواجا وجعلنا نومكم سباتا وجعلنا الليل لباسا وجعلنا النهار معاشا وبنينا فوقكم سبعا شدادا وجعلنا سراجا وهاجا وأنزلنا من المعصرات ماء ثجاجا لنخرج به حبا ونباتا وجنات ألفافا إن يوم الفصل كان ميقاتا يوم ينفخ في الصور فتأتون أفواجا وفتحت السماء فكانت أبوابا وسيرت الجبال فكانت سرابا إن جهنم كانت مرصادا للطاغين مآبا لابثين فيها أحقابا لا يذوقون فيها بردا ولا شرابا إلا حميما وغساقا جزاء وفاقا إنهم كانوا لا يرجون حسابا وكذبوا بآياتنا كذابا وكل شيء أحصيناه كتابا فذوقوا فلن نزيدكم إلا عذابا إن للمتقين مفازا حدائق وأعنابا وكواعب أترابا وكأسا دهاقا لا يسمعون فيها لهوا ولا كذابا جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما الرحمن لا يملكون منه خطابا يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن وقال صوابا ذلك اليوم الحق فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه مآبا إنا أنذرناكم عذابا قريبا يوم ينظر المرء ما قدمت يداه ويقول الكافر يا ليتني كنت ترابا الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم وأبارك على سيدي وحبيبي وقائد محمد بن عبد الله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه إلى يوم الدين من اهتدى فلا مضل له ومن يضلل الله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It gives me great joy and honor to stand here before you, to share something with you about a hereafter, about a place which if it wasn't for that place that Allah had promised us, I don't think any of us would be working in Islam for anything. Or maybe none of us would have hope, but only live with fear, fear from hellfire. Allah created heaven, Jannah. And a Muslim lives a life not only in fear, but a life between hope and fear. We live in hope, hoping that Allah will forgive us and give us mercy, and we enter that everlasting dwelling in Jannah, paradise. And we fear Allah from doing sins because we remember hellfire. And we ask Allah to save us from hellfire. And so a Muslim lives a life of hope, a life of hope, raja, and khawf, fear of hellfire. Brothers and sisters, I have a question for you. What do you wish for? What do you wish for? What do you desire? What do you anticipate to reach? What do you anticipate to reach, brothers and sisters? What is it that you yearn for? What is it that you long for? What is it? Ask yourself that question. What is your ambition? Do you wish for a beautiful wife or a gorgeous husband who has got popularity, who everyone looks up to so that you can show off with him or her? Do you desire a beautiful mansion and lots of money? Is that what you desire? Or do you anticipate to reach a firm, lifelong career? Do you anticipate that? Do you yearn for luxurious dwelling? A land, or probably one day to buy an island of your own? Do you long for fame and popularity and fortune? What do you yearn for? What do you desire? ماذا تشتاق أيها المؤمن? What do you desire? Do you miss having all of that? If this is what you are desiring and anticipating for and yearning for, then my dear brother or sister, you have been deceived. You have been deceived by this world, all of its fortune, all of its beauty. Because this beauty which you see in front of you, as Allah describes it in the Quran, is like a flower that grows in the ground. It gets watered from the rain and then it blossoms. It has a nice fragrance and it looks beautiful. But then it only lasts for about a month or less. And then suddenly it starts to wither away. And you have no more attention towards it. As if it never had existed before and becomes soil and dirt. Allah says in the Quran, اعلموا, know, understand, acknowledge. Learn this, understand this always, be conscious about it, that اعلموا أنما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو وزينة وتفاخر بينكم وتكاثر في الأموال والأولاد. Know that this worldly life, الحياة الدنيا, is only playing لعب, لهو, entertaining yourselves, زينة, decoration, تفاخر بينكم, challenging each other, who can get the best house, who can get the fastest cars, who can look the most beautiful, who can have more money. تفاخر بينكم, Allah says, and this is what the world of life is about. Don't the kuffar do that? Trying to rise in the high levels and positions in work? Yes, they do. And everyone tries to beat everyone else in becoming or reaching that high seat? Yes, it is a life of challenge, challenging each other. وتكاثر في الأموال والأولاد. And people love in this life to have lots of money, lots of children, in order to have a strong back. كمثل غيث أعجب الكفار نباته ثم يهيج فتراه مصفرا ثم يكون حطاما. Like that flower which I gave an example to. This world is like that. It blossoms for a little bit and then it fades away, brothers and sisters. If this is what you are yearning for, longing for, missing, and being anxious about, I'm sad to say, brothers and sisters, that you are in a very great loss. Because when you die, and we all shall die, you're just going to have to leave it all behind you. Subhanallah. All of that, we're going to leave it behind us? Yes, it's not going to be buried with you. The only thing that you will be taking is two things: your family and your actions to the graveyard. But your family will go back and your actions will stay with you. And then it'll be an ugly being, if your actions are bad, to keep you in that bad company until the day of judgment, or it'll be a most handsome person to sit with you and keep you company until the day of judgment. So what do you yearn for and desire? When we read about the companions of the past, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us an example about how they lived and what they yearned for and anticipated and desired. I have chosen a topic called al-mushtaquna ila al-jannah, which means those who desire paradise, not those who desire this world. And I give you examples of the companions of the Prophet in a short while and people who lived before us. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والسابقون السابقون أولئك المقربون والسابقون السابقون أولئك المقربون في جنات النعيم ثلة من الأولين وقليل من الآخرين. And those who have passed us, those who have passed us, Allah says, the ones who have beaten us, beaten us, أولئك المقربون, they are the ones closer to Allah. Where? في جنات النعيم, in high places in Jannah, blessed. ثلة من الأولين, a large amount from the people before us. وقليل, من الآخرين. An unused small amount of them still exist